So my research in the Abbott lab focuses on 3D printing Wagyu steak using fat and muscle cells grown from a cow. The big idea is to produce an animal-based product without necessarily sacrificing an animal. So this can be done through a minimally invasive process to obtain the cells, grow them in the lab until we've reached the desired amount, and then print them into a tissue structure. This process to create cultivated meat can be referred to as cellular agriculture and is a new field that's gaining a lot of momentum.
Historically, my lab has focused on tissue engineering and the role of fat accumulation in a variety of diseases and different applications. So the cellular agricultural research is really an extension of the techniques that we usually use in the lab to create disease models or for different approaches for regenerative medicine. So this is really an exciting new area for the lab where we get to use our biomedical engineering expertise to support the cellular agricultural field. So a large motivator for our research is that as the world population grows and the demand for animal proteins increases, our current agricultural supply chain will be unable to meet the demand for the world's meat products. So another motivator too is that currently livestock are grown in concentrated feeding operations that cause significant environmental, public health, and food shortage issues. Another advantage is also that we can grow cultivated meat products in a matter of weeks as opposed to livestock that take years to grow. So if adopted, cultivated meat products would reduce the amount of environmental impacts of our current agricultural system and also address the growing demand for meat products. In particular, my lab is focused on improving the texture and the flavor of cultivated meat products so that we can improve consumer acceptance of this new food protein.
So because we want to recreate that marbling effect that's seen in a lot of high-end meat products, we actually have conducted an MRI scan on a piece of A5 Japanese Wagyu steak, which has allowed us to generate a 3D rendering of the fat that's found in between the muscle fibers. This is a very specific fat distribution that's known to enhance the flavor and texture of steaks. We also have converted a standard plastic printer into a dual nozzle 3D bioprinter, which will allow us to print the fat cells and the muscle cells simultaneously. And aside from that, we've been working on the 3D printing techniques. So this far we have successfully 3D printed the fat cells, which did prove to be a challenge due to the buoyancy of the fat cell and how fragile they are under shear stress. And we will be moving to 3D printing muscle soon. And once we do that, hopefully we can combine all of our previous techniques along with the MRI scan so that we can 3D print a Wagyu steak using fat and muscle cells grown from a cow.